Coming in at number 8, well, we said that Louis was my favourite on the list, but this guy is definitely a favourite too. Hank Lebioda. Now, the backstory is, if you missed it, I picked him as a dark horse 2 weeks in a row and he finished top 10. We had him as one of our sizzlers and he finished in the top 10. And the momentum was good for him at the 3M Open, but his dad took ill and he had to withdraw from the tournament. And he said on social media afterwards that he just had to go when he found out that his dad was sick, which was obviously the right decision to make. But he's back in action this week. He's 90th in the FedEx Cup standings and 70-1. There's value in Hank.
Again, you know, this top 10 is made up of guys that have no pressure on them. They're going for the top 30. They're, you know, established players, Matsuyama, Masters champion, etc. And now on this back end of the top 10, I'm sort of leaving out all these other guys, Diane, that are starting from cold starts where they've got to literally try to recreate everything. I'm banking on guys like Hank, who's having a great summer. Securities ticket for next year. Again, he's got to be very happy with himself. Everything in his life right now is very smooth and even. And what would be better, he's already tasted it, what, 3 weeks in a row you picked him for top five or something like that. He knows what it feels like to be up in the top five. He's not intimidated anymore by any of this. I think he's going to do well again.